Good morning. Welcome to a new video session. In this session, we will discuss some fundamentals of ultrasonic sounds or ultrasonics. Ultrasonics is a unit in the second semester of BSc students. That is first year BSc, second semester. In this topic of ultrasonics, today in this class we want to discuss a few subtopics, very basic things about the ultrasonics. Right. And one more thing, the present discussion is limited to the extension of the content of the present discussion is limited to the syllabus that is meant for the second semester of the BSc students. Okay, this is only the extent of this discussion will be limited to the syllabus only, right? In this particular thing, okay, the ultrasonics, that is the some introductory topics, we want to discuss what are ultrasonics and what are the general properties of the ultrasonics and what are the applications of the ultrasonics, right? Just before to start, as a matter of revision or recollecting the things, I want to tell something about the sound. Sound is a kind of energy which gives the sensation of hearing for the human being and other creatures. Okay, it means that sound is a kind of energy which gives the sensation of hearing for the living beings. Living beings means human being, the animals and the creatures, some creatures, right, birds and some creatures. Okay, every vibrating system or body produces sound waves. It means that sound waves are generated from the vibrations of bodies or particles or systems. Therefore, sound waves are mechanical waves. Okay, therefore, sound needs a medium for the propagation. Right? The thing is, sound waves are mechanical waves. They are generated by the vibration of particles or bodies or systems. And at the same time, they can propagate only in a medium. They doesn't propagate in vacuum. Okay, therefore, sound needs a medium for its generation and for its propagation also. Such a kind of energy is sound. These are all very, very, very fundamentals regarding to the sound that you have already learned in your high school stages and also in the intermediate by higher secondary stage. Okay, so many things are in detail you studied by all the students in the said stages of your journey as a student. Okay, whatever it might be, again I want to just recollect them. This is about the basis of the sound. Okay, it gives the sensation of hearing, it generates only in a medium, and it propagates only in a medium. Right, all sounds are not audible to the human being. All sounds are not audible to the human being. Only certain part of the sounds are audible to the human being. These sounds that are audible to the human being are known as the audible sounds. Right. Therefore, depends upon the human audibility factor or depends upon the factor of human audibility about the sound is divided into three categories. One is the audible category of sound. The other one is the infrasound. The third one is the ultrasonic sound. Okay, audible sound, infrasonics, and ultrasonics. Okay, right. Audible sounds means these sounds that are audible for the human being are known as the audible sounds. What is limit? Okay, man can able to, or human being can, the general human being can able to hear sounds of frequencies ranging from 20 Hz to 20 kHz. Okay, what is the audible limit of human being? It is 20 Hz to 20 kHz. Right. These sounds that are whose frequencies less than the 20 Hz are known as the infrasonics. These sounds whose frequencies less than 20 Hz are known as the infrasonics. These sounds whose frequencies more than 20 kHz are known as the ultrasonics. Okay, that's why we have infrasonics, we have audible sounds, and ultrasonics. This is also very familiar to all of you in your lower standards of studies. Okay, as far as the sound is concerned, Now we want to discuss about what is this one? Ultrasound, ultrasonics. Again, just I want to tell, what is the audibility limit of the human? It is 20 Hz to 20 kHz. This is the frequency limit. This is the frequency limit of audibility, that is 20 Hz to 20 kHz. What is the wavelength limit? 17 meters to the 17 millimeters. It means that an human being, okay, an ordinary human being can able to heard the sounds whose wavelength means the length of the wave is either 2 meters or up to 2 millimeters. Sorry, 20 meters up to 20 millimeters. 20, no. It is 17 meters to 17 millimeters. 17 meters to 17 millimeters. Okay, nearly about 17 meters to 17 millimeters. That is the audibility limit of the wavelength of the ultrasonics. Please correct this one. What is this one? Frequency limit is 20 Hz to 20 kHz and wavelength limit is 17 meters to 17 millimeters in air at lab temperature. That is also in air at lab temperature. That should be also very clear. Okay, in air at lab temperature. Okay, human can able to hear the sounds of wavelength of 17 meters to 17 millimeters. 17 meters to 17 millimeters. Right. Sound waves with frequencies higher than the upper audibility limit are known as the, or limit of human being are known as the ultrasonic sounds. That's why what is our present topic? We want to discuss about the ultrasonics. What are ultrasonics? Ultrasonics are the sounds whose frequencies more than the 20 kHz or whose wavelength is less than 17 millimeters. Less than 17 millimeters. Okay? Right. The term sonic is applied to ultrasound. The word sonic is generally associated with ultrasound only. Ultrasound means, okay, it means that very high. They are inaudible to the human ear. Okay, this is very known to you. They have short wavelength, right? Their wavelength is less than 17 millimeters. Since they are high energy, waves can propagate well. As the ultrasonics are high frequency sound waves. That's why their energy is also very, very high. That's why, okay, they can propagate quite well. Dogs, bats and grasshoppers can detect ultrasonics. Okay, dogs and grasshoppers, bats and grasshoppers can produce and can hear ultrasonics. Dogs can hear the ultrasonics. Okay, dogs can only hear the ultrasonics, whereas bats and grasshoppers can produce and, okay, they can receive or hear the ultrasonics. Very, very important. The audibility limit to for human beings slightly varies for person to person. That is a, of course, simple thing. Okay, it is not so. Okay, person to person, it is slightly variable. Ultrasound devices operate with frequencies from 20 kHz up to several gigahertz. ultrasound devices, the devices are the apparatus or the system that uses the ultrasounds can operate from what frequency? 20 kilohertz to several gigahertz. Very, very important. Okay, gigahertz. Right, giga means 10 to the power of 9 hertz. Children can hear some high-pitched sounds than the older elders cannot hear. It means that children can able to hear high-pitched sounds and high-frequency sounds than the older people. It means that older people upper audibility limit is somewhat less when compared with the upper audibility limit of the children. Okay, whatever the high frequency waves that are heard by the children cannot be audible to human old people, aged human being, because in humans the upper limit of pitch of hearing tends to decrease with age. Therefore, in case of human being, if age increases, so the upper limit of audibility, upper limit of frequency of audibility decreases. It means that their upper audibility limit is not 20 kilohertz, it is less than 20 kilohertz in case of old people. Right. Bats use a variety of ultrasonic ranging echolocation techniques to detect their prey. What is one? Birds use ultrasonic ranging system, ranging technique, that is what is known as echolocation. It means that by means of the echo, echo means reflected sound, by means of the echo of the ultrasonics, they can able to detect their food. Okay, their food. They can able to detect the their food, and they will use the frequencies so beyond 100 kilohertz, possibly 200 kilohertz. Bat can able to produce an air. Frequencies even more than 100 kilohertz, sometimes 200 kilohertz also. Many insects have good ultrasonic hearing. Not only bats, so many insects are also having good ultrasonic hearing. And most of these are nocturnal insects. Listening for echolocating bats and escape being caught. Most of the insects that can able to hear the ultrasonics can able to escape from the echolocation system of the bat. It means that the ultrasound that are produced by the bats can be heard, can be received by the insects, and they can estimate that something is happening and they can easily escape, by the cut off what is on the bats. Okay, very interesting thing as far as the what is on some systems that are there in the nature. Right, ultrasonic frequency trigger a reflection action in the noctoid mouth that causes it to drop slightly in its flight to evade attack. The thing is, in case of some insects, they can also produce ultrasonics. Okay, they can produce the ultrasonics which is different from the ultrasonics that are produced by the bats. It means that they will disturb the ultrasonics produced by the bats. When they disturb the ultrasonics produced by the bats, then bats cannot estimate their prey properly. That is the way, that is the other way to escape from the danger from the bats also. Tiger moth. Okay, moths are a kind of pitching insects. Tiger moths means big moths also emit two clicks which may disturb the bats echolocation. Okay, the tiger moths and the big size moths can produce the clicks, a kind of ultrasonic flickers, which will disturb the bats echolocation also. Very interesting thing that we have to know. Dogs and cats hearing range extended into the ultrasound, and the top end of the dog's hearing range is about 45 kHz, whereas cats is 64 kHz. Dogs and cats hearing range is in ultrasonic region. Top end of the dog's highest range of the dog's hearing range is about 45 kilohertz, whereas for cats it is 64 kilohertz. Dog's whistle is a whistle that emits also sound, used for training and calling dogs. Okay. The frequency of the dog's whistle is within the range of 23 to 54 kilohertz. There is a device which is known as the dog's whistle. It produces ultrasonic sound. It produces ultrasonic sound of ranging 23 kHz to 54 kHz. What is for this one? This is used to train the dogs and call the dogs and use the dog and it is used to give the signals for the dogs, okay, in order to hunt different animals. Okay, that is a device which is known as the dog whistle. Toothed whales, including dolphins, can hear ultrasound and use such sounds in their navigation system, biosonar, to orient and to capture prey. Okay. Here also, that is in case of the things that are living in the oceans, that is toothed whales and whales and dolphins, so they can make use of their own system, that is what is known as the biosonar. This biosonar can able to navigate the direction and location of their prey. Their prey means their food. By means of this food, they can able to locate their food and catch their food as far as these two things are concerned. Porpoises, dolphin-like sea animal. Okay, dolphin-like. Porpoises is a kind of a dolphin. Having a long nose. Long sharp nose, a dolphin like or a dolphin having a long sharp nose is known as porpoises. It is a sea animal and it has the highest range of upper hearing limit, that is 160 kilohertz. Okay, this kind of dolphin has the highest audibility range, that is 160 kilohertz, which is there in the ultrasonic region. Several types of fish can detect the ultrasound. There are so many kinds of fishes that can ultrasound. As far as my knowledge is concerned and my observation is concerned, okay, some fishes can able to detect ultrasonics of frequency 250 kHz also, 240 to 250 kHz also, right. Ultrasound generator speaker systems are sold as electronic pest control devices. Okay, ultrasonic generator and speaker systems are sold as ultrasonic pest control devices. Pest control devices means, these devices are used to remove the, or used to tighten the quadrants, insects, rats and such things, okay, in order to tighten away the rats, quadrants and the insects. Electronic pest control systems are developed. Okay, they are developed on the principle of ultrasound generator and speakers. But of course, there is no scientific evidence for the for the working of these devices. But they are widely used in so many places. Invisible fence is a system of ultrasounds to avoid unwanted dogs and pets inside the compound. Very interesting thing. Invisible fence. A fence, it is not, which is not invisible. What is a fence? To bound something. What to bound? To bound the pet animals. What are the pet animals? Dogs and cats. In order to bound dogs and cats within the compound of a person, within the compound of a family, they are used invisible fence. It means that invisible fence can able to avoid unwanted dogs and unwanted pets. The pets and the dogs that are outside cannot allowed by means of the invisible fence. It means that the system, the ultrasonic system that is there in that compound will act as an invisible fence and they will frighten and avoid the other dogs and other pets that will try to enter into the compound of a person. That is what is known as invisible fence. Okay. Ultrasound sensors are used to put the pet animals within the region meant for their normal life. This is opposite this one. Okay. That is, the pet animals, that is again the dogs and the cats, which will act as a pet to a family, okay, they will arrange some ultrasonic sonar to the belt of their neck. Okay, by means of that ultra sensor, they can easily locate their pet dogs and pet cats and pet animals, okay, so that they want to maintain them within their normal compound or normal region. If sometimes if they want to try to escape from that one, they can easily detect and they will control that one. For that one, they will make use of ultrasonic sensors. Right. Ultrasound identification is a real-time location system or indoor positioning system. Ultrasound identification system is a real-time locating system. Real-time locating system or location. Indoor positioning system, okay, within the walls, how to identify the things. This is a technology used to automatically track and identify. This is a technology used automatically, which will works automatically to track and identify the locations of small objects in real time using a simple thing, that is badges or tags attached to or embedded in the objects and devices. Okay, there are small badges or tags that are embedded or stitched to the objects and devices or plus as far as the things is concerned. In order to identify them, we can make use of this ultrasound identification system. This is a real-time locating system or indoor positioning system. Right. Here also, just a tablet format is given in order to tell about the range of audibility range of a human being when compared with the other animals, which can able to hear more sounds, ultrasonic sounds, okay, right, as far as the other animals is concerned. Right. Now let us switch into the main common properties of the ultrasonic waves, ultrasonics. First one, their frequency is high, that's why they are highly energetical waves, therefore they have high energy content. Second one, they can travel long distances as they are highly directional. Ultrasonics are highly directional. Because of this property, they can propagate over a long distances. They travel with the speed of sound in a given medium, but not in vacuum. That is everything. In a given medium, they will travel with the velocity which is equal to the velocity of the sound, and they won't travel in the vacuum. Right. Their velocity remains constant in homogeneous medium. In a given homogeneous medium, their velocity is constant. Okay. In non-homogeneous medium, its speed of propagation increases with increasing frequency. Okay. In case of non-homogeneous medium, okay, if its frequency increases, so its velocity also increases, its speed also increases. It means that in a non-homogeneous medium, the speed of ultrasonics is proportional to their frequency. If more is the frequency of ultrasonics, more is the speed of propagation of the ultrasonics. Very interesting thing. It produces hearing effects. Hearing aids means, okay, deaf and dumb people can able to hear or having hearing aids. That's why in hearing aids also, okay, hearing aids are some systems. They are also used, right? They are able to drill and cut the thin metals. Very interesting thing. They are energetical. That's why they can able to drill and cut the thin material, thin metals. These waves can weld certain plastics and metals. They can weld certain plastics and metals also. They can produce vibrations in low viscosity liquids. In case of low density liquids, they can produce vibrations. Very interesting thing. When ultrasonics are allowed to pass through, okay, thin liquids with low density, they can produce the vibrations. When ultrasonics are passed through liquids, it produces stationary wave spectrum and makes the liquid to behave as a acoustical grating. Very interesting thing. Just now I said that when ultrasonics are allowed to pass through low density liquids or low viscous liquids, they can produce vibrations. Right, okay? These vibrations, because of these vibrations, when the vibrations are generated in the liquid, it propagates towards the wall of the container. At the wall of the container, the wave reflects. The incident wave and reflected wave will overlap together and produce a stationary wave pattern. That's why when ultrasonics are allowed to pass in a low density liquids, they can produce vibrations and then they can produce stationary wave pattern. Stationary wave pattern means compressions and rarefactions. It means that low density regions and high density regions. It means that when ultrasonics are allowed to pass through low density liquids, okay, certain layers are, some layers are divided into low density layers and high density layers, low density layers and high density layers. This pattern of low density layer, high density layer followed by one after other, okay, will be happened. This is what is known as the acoustical grating. Now the liquid will act as an acoustical grating. Very interesting thing, because of the propagation of ultrasonic sounds in certain low density liquids or low viscous liquids, okay, they can produce low density layer, high density layer, low density layer and high density layer. They can produce, they can divide the liquid into the layers of low density, high density, followed by one after other. Now this will act as a acoustic grating, right? The ultrasonic waves are reflected and refracted just like light waves. Ultrasonic waves are also reflected. They have the property of reflection and refraction also. The speed of the ultrasonic waves is more in more dense media. Very interesting. Speed of the ultrasonic media is ultrasonic waves are more in more denser media. It means that if the density of the medium increases, so the speed of the ultrasonics also increases. This is also one of the notable thing as far as the properties of the ultrasonics is concerned. They mix molten metals of widely different densities. They can able to mix molten metals of widely different densities to produce the alloys of uniform composition. They are using the alloys industry in that way. This is about the very common associated things to the ultrasonics in order to understand the nature of the ultrasonics. The nature of the ultrasonics. That's why I discussed all those things in the introduction of ultrasonics itself. Okay, look, that's why these are the properties. They will come under the category of what is some properties of the ultrasonics. Okay, basic properties of the ultrasonics. Next, come to the application part. Uses of the ultrasonics. One is as a cleaning system. In objects with parts that are difficult to reach, the process of ultrasonics cleaning is used. In case of some spiral tubes, some electronic components, it is difficult to reach that part, that places. Okay, for that one, we make use of ultrasonic cleaning system. Okay, which are cleaned in a solution with the cleaning material and the ultrasonic waves are passed into it. Okay, these objects are placed in some liquid that is suitable for that one, by and with a cleaning material, and ultrasonics are sent into that one. When ultrasonics send into that liquid, then what will happen? It produces waves, and the high frequency waves can able to penetrate inside the small parts, and they can able to remove the dirt and grease to detach from the surfaces of the components. Okay, very interesting one. Detection of cracks. Ultrasound is used to detect the cracks in the metallic components that are used in the construction of high-rise structures such as buildings, bridges. Okay, very important. They can identify with the echo effects of the ultrasound. Very important, interesting application. In case of the construction of buildings, bridges and dams, we can make use of huge and very heavy girders, iron and other steel and other metallic girders are used. They are heavy cutters. Okay. There may be a possibility of small cracks inside that one. That interior cracks of huge rigid body materials can be detected by the ultrasound by means of the echo effects of the ultrasonic. Echo means reflection of the ultrasonics. Next, echocardiography. Cardiography means heart to imaging system. Echocardiography means it works on the principle of echo of the sound. In the process of echocardiography, the ultrasonic waves are used to form image of heart using reflection and detection of the waves from various parts. Okay, ultrasonic sounds are allowed to send to the different parts, and they will get the information. By means of that information, we can make use of the what is on an image of the heart, okay, in order to identify its function and so many other information as far as the working of the heart is concerned. Ultrasonography, medical ultrasound is a diagnostic imaging technique, diagnostic imaging technique. It is used to imaging of the internal body structures such as muscles, joints and internal organs. Okay, in all, they are used to image, they are used to picturize the internal body structures like muscles, joints, internal organs. Okay, ultrasonic images are known as sonograms. They are known as sonograms, right? These sonograms, ultrasonic imaging sonograms, so he is with the object with 3 gigahertz sound wave produces the resolution comparable to the optical image. Okay, the images are also comparable to the optical imaging system also. It means that they are as better as optical imaging system, right? Lithotripsy is a process. Ultrasonic waves are used to break the stones in the kidney. That particular system is known as lithotripsy. High energy sounds are passed through the body without injuring it and break the stones into small pieces as far as the kidney is concerned. And of course, these small pieces can easily come out through urine. And of course, this kind of system is used to remove the stones in the kidneys. They are known as the lithotripsy. Next, sonar. This is a very, very, very important application. This particular sonar system will be a short answer as far as the student's aspect is concerned. That's why students are requested to take or write their own note, okay, which is suitable for this one. Here only 3 lines are there, but I will explain very clearly. Therefore, you are requested to prepare a note as far as the sonar system is concerned, because it is a short answer to you. Sonar means sound navigation and ranging. It is a technique or it is a system. Sound navigation and ranging. It means that ultrasonic sound, by means of the ultrasonic sound, navigation and ranging is possible as far as the body's objects on the surface and inside the sea or ocean. Right? That's why what is a sonar? Sonar is a system used to identify. Ranging means identify the location of the objects. The location of the objects. Navigation means not only the location, but also they are used to estimate the course of motion, its way of motion. Okay, that is what is totally known as the sonar system. That's why again I will repeat it very clearly for the sake of the students in a proper order. Sonar is an abbreviation for sound navigation and ranging. It is a system. It is used ultrasonic sounds. It is used to identify the location, and it is also used to estimate the way of propagation or way of motion of a body on the surface of the sea or inside the sea water. It means that you can able to locate an object, and also you can able to estimate the course of motion, its way of motion. It means that the direction of motion, its velocity, and everything will be always estimated or always given by the solar system to you, like a radar in the air. Radar is used in the air. Okay, right. That's why it is what is known as the navigation and ranging system. Location of the object and also to know the way of motion, that is the course of motion of the body. With this technique, ultrasonics are used to detect and trace the warships or submarines. Okay, actually they are used to identify the warships and submarines. Okay, And also, ultrasonar sonar system is used to identify the mineral deposits inside the sea and the depth of the sea. You can able to get the mineral deposits inside the sea and depth of the sea, various resources that are there in the sea and various things that are there inside the sea about as far as the ecosystem inside the sea is concerned. Ocean ecosystem is concerned. We can get much of the information from the ocean ecosystem. Right. That's why in sonar system we can make use of ultrasound. Okay, what is the working principle of the ultrasonar? Working principle of ultrasonar system is echo of the ultrasonic sounds. Echo means reflection of the ultrasonic sounds. It is used to identify the submarine ships, not only that one, mineral deposits, depth of the water, and so many other information regarding to the things that are there inside the oceans and seas. Echolocation, already this was discussed in the introduction. Echolocation process is where the sound waves and echo are used to determine the objects in the space. In order to determine the location and their motion in the space is known as the echolocation system. It is used by the bats to navigate and find their food. Navigate means to find their food, and also they can make use of this one in order their own navigation, their own motion also. They can move only by means of this system also. Bats send ultrasonic sounds from their mouth and nose, which then hits the objects in their vicinity, producing echoes. Which are then received by the bats. The nature of the echo helps them to determine the size, the shape, and the distance of the object. The echo sound that is produced by the bats, which is reflected from the body, the nature of the echo sound helps them to say about the size of the object, shape of the object, and the distance of the object. As far as their prey is concerned. In that way, they will get the total information as far as the insects and other objects that it will eat or it will make use as a prey. Right. And I said that in the same topic, in the beginning I said that the other insects are also able to produce the ultrasonics or hear the ultrasonics. The other insects have the ultrasonics and they can try to escape from the bats also. In case of some insects, they can produce ultrasonics other than the bats, and they will disturb the echo location system of the bats. In that way, they can also escape from the bats. That is a kind of a beautiful thing that is happening as far as the nature is concerned. Right. Industrially, ultrasound is used for cleaning, mixing and accelerating the chemical process. Accelerating means ultrasonics are used as catalytic agents in order to promote the chemical reaction. Also using for cleaning purpose and mixing purpose. Physical therapy, physiotherapy, it is known as the physical therapy means physiotherapy. Ultrasonics are used for the treatment of ligament sprains, muscle strains, tendonitis, joint inflammation, rheumatic arthritis and osteoarthritis. In order to remove such things, ultrasound is used as a physiotherapeutic agent. Right. Ultrasonic disintegration. The ultrasonic disintegration means by means of the ultrasonic sound, biological cells including bacteria can be disintegrated. It means that we can able to kill the bacteria and harmful cells by means of ultrasonics because of their high energy, right? They can able to kill the bacteria in savage also. In savage, they can able to kill the bacteria for that purpose also. They are usually in wireless communication because their highly directional signaling systems are used. They are highly directional. They are used in highly directional signaling systems. Highly energetical and highly directional. Right. Acoustic microscopy. This is a very interesting thing. Acoustic microscopy is a technique using sound waves to visualize structures too small to resolve by the human eye. We can able to make use of acoustic microscope by using ultrasound in order to see small objects and small parts which are not visible with our naked eye. Frequencies of several gigahertz are used in this one. Again, reflection and diffraction effects can able to give the such information as far as this one is concerned. Medical ultrasound is an ultrasound based diagnostic medical imaging system. Just I said that too. Medical imaging system in order to visualize muscles, tendons and many internal organs to capture the size, structure and any pathological lesions with real time tomography images. By means of real time tomographic images, we can capture their pictures in order to see the, in order to study about the size, structure and other disorders by means of medical sound. That is what is known as what is some medical imaging technique, right? In the veterinary field also, okay, by the year 2005 onwards, ultrasound technique is began to use by the beef cattle industry. They are using the beef cattle industry in order to improve animal health and yield. Very important, in beef cattle industry, ultrasonic techniques are used in order to improve the animal health and yield of the cattle operation, yield of the cattle production. Very important, beef production. Ultrasound is used to evaluate fat thickness. It is used to evaluate the thickness of the fat, rib, eye area. Okay, thickness of the fat in the rib and eye area, and intramuscular fat in living animals. They are also used to study the or estimate the thickness of intramuscular fat living in the living animals. Right. It is also used to evaluate health and the characteristics of unborn calves. Okay, small calves. They are used to estimate that one. Right. Not only that one. Here you can able to see very interesting thing. That is, okay, a baby that is grown in the womb of mother. We can able to get the total image of the growth of the baby in the womb of mother. Okay, by means of ultrasonic system. Okay, you can able to see this one, which is nothing, which is a ultrasound imaging system. Okay, by means of this one, okay, medical people can able to study everything regarding to the growth and the state of the growing tail in the womb of this one. That's why this is what is known as the fetal ultrasound system or fetal ultrasound imaging system. Right. This is very interesting one. That's why these are all the some uses of what this one, ultrasonic sound. Okay. It is a very part of what this one, sound energy with the high frequency and low wavelength, but having many applications not only in the industry but also in our common life and so many other fields. Okay, in so many dimensions also. Okay, right. This is about all about the ultrasonics and their common properties and their applications. See you in the next class.